Hello everyone, this is Joseph K. Welcome back to more Let's Play Tales of the Abyss 100%, and we are finally ready to finish this off. Since last time, I went and I maxed out on pretty much everything I could get. I didn't get special gels or lottery gels. I think you can buy them, but they're like ridiculously expensive. But I did max out on my Melange, Miracle, Orange Gel, Apple Gel, Lemon Gel. And I also maxed out on Life Bottles. Now, a couple things I want to do. First off, let's return to whoever was cooking whatever. I think we're on fried rice, right? Because, yeah, everybody's maxed out on fried chicken, so fried rice. All right. Tyr is cooking fried rice. I don't know how many more times she's got to cook fried rice, though, so I'm going to go ahead and have Jade cook the fried rice. Because I don't want to max out my rice, my fried rice, while I'm in the process of doing this. And that's waste ingredients, you know? And it doesn't look like you get a skit for getting into a match with Natalia as the Malku Thief. I swear we do, though. But maybe you gotta get into a match with everybody in the party. I don't know. Anyways, come talk to this lady. And you might be asking yourself, why did you buy items? You can't use items at the Colosseum. Oh, well, you'll see. You'll see, viewers. Team Tournament Advanced Level. Yep. So, you can approach what we're going to do two different ways. You can go for more damage and less healing. In which case, it would behoove you to bring Luke or Guy, depending on whom you're playing as. Or whom you prefer playing as, because you may not be playing with either of them. And then, for your second character to do damage, pick either Luke or Guy, whomever you didn't pick. Alternatively, you could also pick Annis. And it might not be too bad to pick Annis, because she does constantly heal herself. But anyways, let's go. And y'all, I'm excited for this. I've been waiting for this. So, yes, let's go in. Okay. Yep. Oh, we can survive. The first round is two lesser goblins, a goblin, and a great goblin. Now, I just wanted to make sure I could see the round. Now, the great goblin has 45,000 HP on this difficulty, with 552 physical attack, 349 physical defense, 401 phonic attack, and 293 phonic defense. It's not weak to anything. It's not resistant to anything. It can drop a Carmine Chamber. You can also steal a Carmine Chamber from it. And since Jade has the Meteor Storm, he's basically gonna pwn everything. Well, that wasn't too hard, was it? We got a Fireward bug. I do believe the regular Goblin drops that. Now, for round two, we are gonna have an enemy known as a Tyrantois. Check this bad boy out.
You're dead.
All right, so the Tyrantois here has 94,000 HP, 597 physical attack, 575 physical defense, 485 phonic attack, and 316 phonic defense. It's not weak to anything, however, it is resistant to water and physical attacks. It doesn't drop anything, you can't steal anything from it. Might as well.
Now die!
Ow, ow, get off me. Hey, all right.
That's your best?
Not too hard. These battles really aren't that hard. Now that we got a whole team, oh yeah, they're not that bad. They see a trail of corpses and they head up the more of the same, yet their gait never falters. For the sake of the future that lies beyond, they press onward as long as even a drop of courage remains in their joined hands. Now, the time has come for their bonds to become legend, be it a happy victory or a bitter defeat. This will be the last battle. Final round, start! Against something we've already seen before. This is the dragon, the same exact dragon that we fought in the Dragon Buster minigame. The dragon has 98,000 HP, 641 physical attack, 615 physical defense, 516 phonic attack, 338 phonic defense. It can drop a dragon fang, you can steal a dragon fang. No weaknesses, no resistances. And Jay's just going for the hole. Okay, Jade's basically gonna kill the dragon. Oh, not quite yet.
Get out of my base.
All right. Are we ready? Oh, you thought that was the end? Oh, no, 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 no. No, 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 no. Spoiler alert, we got more. I moved. Move beyond words. At this very moment, a new legend has been born. A tale to be told for generations to come. Luke's team has cleared the final battle, overcome a sea of fearsome foes. And finally emerged victorious as the new champions. All right. In honor of your glorious victory, we present you 75,000 gold in prize money. and a gold trophy. Marvelous, wonderful, I'm moved to tears. Everyone, let's give him the greatest round of applause this world has ever heard. The time has come to say goodbye until it's time for the next... Wait, everyone, don't just leave yet. Don't leave just yet. A new challenger has appeared. Going to hold an exhibition match. Ready? Go! And who do we have an exhibition match with?
Be careful, they're strong.
Mitt Adnane, Felia Phyllis, Natalie Fletch, Reed Herschel. The cameo battles. And, in my opinion, one of the most fun battles in the entire game. And this will challenge you. It's not nearly as powerful, as hard as the other optional super boss that's in here. But, for what it's worth, let's run down the accolades of these people. Mitt Adnane. We first saw Mitt Adnane in Tales of Phantasia. She was the white mage that joined our party after her mother died. I did Tales of Phantasia on my channel. Coming up after her, we have Felia Phyllis. Felia Phyllis first made her appearance in Tales of Destiny. I don't know how she comes into the party because I've actually not played that far into Tales of Destiny. Not far enough to get her. At least I don't think. Maybe I do have her. I don't know. After her, we have Ms. Natalie Fletch. Ms. Natalie Fletch first made her appearance in Tales of Destiny 2. The actual Tales of Destiny 2. Not the Tales of Destiny 2 that was later turned into Eternia. Tales of Eternia. Speaking of Tales of Eternia, we have Mr. Reed Herschel. Now, let me run down these people for you. Your first order of business should be get rid of Mitt Adnane. Mitt Adnane is annoying because she has the ability to heal her fellow party members. And, oh boy, that is not fun. So get her out the way first. You might want to just put Luke on her and have everybody else target anyone who's not her. Or if you really are feeling it, you might want to throw somebody else to help you take out Mint. But let's do the, because we can use items in here. Let's use a magic lens on her. She doesn't have anything you can steal from her. Actually, I don't think any of these have anything you can steal from them. No, they don't. Also, there's that. You've seen her. Now, watch that. That move sucks. Then, after you take out Mint, the next person you want to get out of there is Natalie. No, Felia. Get Felia out. Natalie is an archer, much like Natalia is. As you see, no weaknesses. And again, like I said, you can't steal anything from her. All right. After you get out Felia, you probably want to take out Reed Herschel, because he's going to do a lot of damage to your party. One other thing I should point out that these lovely characters love doing. These characters absolutely love using life bottles. Now, the higher difficulty you are with them, the more frequently they're going to use life bottles. And that is not good, because it'll revive them all the 50,000, half their HP. Which, when you get down to Nanalee and Reed, that brings them both back up to over 100,000 HP on unknown difficulty. You don't want that. I'm actually gonna turn this to mint. And then let's get Reed Herschel taken care of, and then we're gonna get rid of mint. So, Reed Herschel was actually in Tales of Destiny 2, which I think the actual Tales of Destiny 2 is the one with the number, not the Roman numeral, like I said before. And they were in the Tales of Destiny 2 that got Americanized, which wasn't really truly Tales of Destiny 2. The reason why it was named Tales of Destiny 2 was because they were trying to play off of the Tales of Destiny that came out. But in actuality, the original Tales of Destiny, the real original Destiny 2, never really made it into the U.S. Alright, now I want to get her out of the way. You guys need to get off me. Well, that sucks. Actually, I'm gonna bring myself back. Okay, I actually really want to have, Alright, I'm going to go ahead and use some items on Tyr. We're going to use, Well, actually, she doesn't need that. She's good on TP. HP. Let's use, Pineapple Gel on her. Watch yourself. Hey, alright. I'm going to go ahead and use another pineapple latchy. Alright, I'm going to use a miracle gel on Natalia. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and use a special gel on myself. Good. Good, good, good. And finally, I'm going to get myself a good old, do I want Miracle Gel? Yeah, you know, I'll just use a Miracle Gel on, Alright, now we're good to go. Oh, Mint is using first aid on everybody. No. Bring me back so I can take her out. Son of a bitch! Jade, I need you to bring yourself back.
Go! Bring it back!
And then, Natalia, I need you to bring me back.
Take it back out! Bring it back!
Reed's really annoying the hell out of me. You know what? I need somebody to go after her with me. You guys are really taking a long time to heal me. Jay, I don't know what you're doing, but bring me back. Get her out of here. Okay, she's out. All right, Felia. Keep in mind, they can use life bottles on their opponent, their partners. All right, Tyr, I need you to use a miracle gel on yourself. How is she doing? Okay. Alright. I gotta bring Tyr back. This is why you really want to get... Damn, they keep double teaming me. Jesus. Bring me back, Natalia. Oh, we got two meteor storms going at once. Alright, I need you to use a miracle gel on yourself. Alright, she's out. Get Reed out the way, because Reed's annoying me. Tyr, bring me back. Actually, she might be able to do this on me. Resurrect me. Natalia, why are you falling like that? Miracle gel on yourself.
Blessing drops.
Oh, shit.
Demon
Oh shit, I didn't realize he had his Oh, she healed herself. Okay. Natalia, my dear, I need you to use a miracle gel on... Oh, she... What? She doesn't have an item thrower? Oh, that sucks. Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and heal myself again. Yeah. Come on now, get Reed out of the way. How's he doing on health? Oh, he's almost done. All right, we almost have him. That's fine, that's fine, that's fine. Sure, let's use a miracle gel on yourself. We did it, y'all! Woo!
Well, you did your best.
Oh, and by the way, we get a lot of really good stuff. So, what did we lose out on? Hey, hey! Jade learned add skill endure. Ow! Ow! Minus 4.98. Minus 5.98. Minus 7.88. We are 7.88 grade. But you know, the good news is, they didn't at all revive their party members. That's another reason why you want to take out Mint first. Victory! Yahoo! Bravo! Another reason why you want to take Mint out first is because if you take somebody else out before Mint, she can revive them. Just like Tyr can resurrect us. And honestly, you don't want that. Now, shortly here, we should be getting a skit. Sorry I wasn't talking much. That is a fun battle, but it requires a lot of concentration. Not nearly as much concentration as required to, fight the other super boss that I know of in this game. That one, you really need to be on your toes. The Mysterious Colosseum Fighters. Who do you think those real tough guys were who came out at the end? They were summoned by the Master of the Colosseum, I must say. Their abilities would be useful in battle. I was curious too, so I asked around. Apparently, he could temporarily summon illusional matter. Wait, that was an illusion? From a dimensional rift to another universe. Yeah, that does sound useful. But since they are only illusions, any damage they cause to their opponents is likewise illusionary. The pain is real enough so you can fall unconscious, but... so they can't kill or be killed. Then I suppose there's little point in researching this for the Malkuth army. Yes, it would only be useful for torture. You two had better not be serious. The Colosseum owners do only doing this for entertainment. I won't let anyone use it for things like that. Alright! So that's why we have all of our health back and whatever. Alright, now that we did that, let's get our party back the way it was. I don't actually need to put Guy back in the party now, considering, I'm not really going to be using his center anymore. But will we be able to make it into Eldred and evade the heavy artillery fire, the anti-air cannons, and all that fun stuff? And how many people are waiting for us before we get to Van? Find out next time on Let's Play Tales of the Abyss 100%. This is Joseph Kang signing out. Y'all have a great day and keep it real. Later.